are not right. Today we are flying with Qantas Flight, special flying to Apple, flying out of Canberra, and we're making our way to Sydney on the early morning service. It is 6:30 AM local time, and we are in a cold and dark state of the aircraft, and we are ready to jump aboard and get it going. I have the flight plan and all of that information already programmed in. I've got the ATC up and running, I've got the fuel loads calculated. Still some work to be done there, but that's pretty much all done. I just have to input it into the aircraft. Excuse me. But an Australian Air Force plane, they're looking really bad with its paint. And we've got some rain happening now. So my traffic program that I've got running at the moment, my traffic six, is not exactly perfect. But it is still pretty good. So anyway, let's just jump into the flight deck and get this bird ready to go. We're due for departure at 7:15.
Bank angle.
A few of those are all turned on. Turn on the flight management computers and radios. And we want to align all the screens. So that's all connected, that's all good. What we are actually doing is to... External power on and bus times on. Now the IC external power off. We'll do a fire test. That's all in order. Right, let's get this set up ready for flight. Put that into plan mode. What we're going to do first, actually, is just... Oh, that's right. I have problems with using TSX at Canberra Airport. Because it's actually selecting Hugh, Sierra, Charlie, Bravo. Where it should be, as an example here, we could jump into here, it should be connected to, or that's what it doesn't say it there, but it should be connected to Canberra, which is why SCB and Casillero Charlie Bravo, or, yeah, that's what it should be connected to, and it's not for some reason. Let's actually just see if I can quickly force it to connect correctly. air traffic control. Because for Canberra Airport, it detects a few different runs. There's three different runs listed for Canberra. And it's listing the run that doesn't have any of the parking positions set. So I just got to figure out how to switch that over to the standard Canberra Airport. But I did not know if that's possible or not. Well, it probably is. I think it's through the AFCAD files, actually, now that I look at it. Because it is using this one. Where is it taking that from? Looking at it. Let's actually see if I can quickly fix this. Because I've been meaning to do this for a long time, so I might as well just do it. Orbitz FTXAU. FTXAAYSCB. Scenery. Oops. Orbitz SCB. Just what I have an idea what to do. It's a BTL file. That should run. Let's see, standard Canberra Airport one here. For it, I'm not too sure. What we'll do anyway, we'll turn this into a passive file. So what we'll just also quickly do, we're just going to go into add-ons. So if I click me now, go back into, I assume we've closed this up in the first place. I might end up cutting this out of the video, we'll see what happens. Oh, wrong airport. There we go. This might have been too slow now to do it while it's restarting, because if I do it while it's restarting, it doesn't tell me that it's unable to do it. I don't want to have to restart flights, so if I have to do that, I'm just not. What we'll do, we'll actually disable GSX. See if it lets us do it now. Now it is going to be temperamental. I know I have done it while you're going through it before. I have done this. So I could have sworn I am able to do it. Oh, that's just got me very frustrated. I just want to have working GSX at Canberra Airport. That's so frustrating. Just worry about it another time. It's just frustrating, taking away from the realism and what I wanted to do for the video. Tried to fix it enough a time. pilots just continue doing their flight plan. So what we'll do, we'll put in our fill, which is going to be 1349. We'll send that to your sim. Must have just been from your fill calling this. Fill on board is 1349. Now we just want to also get some afferent information, which is our zero fill rate, which is 25524. There we go. Now we jump into flight plan here and we do our flight plan. So we start off by just putting the camera off. It's it. IKMIR1. So number one. And we want to return to this one. Now, air traffic control might assign us a different runway for arrival, but we will put in what we know what to expect. So that's ready to go. If we should die. Give us our expected approach. That was the wrong one. There we go. Now we come back into flight plan. And what we are going to do is come over here and see what we've got going on here. So our first one is OTORI. Trying to remember how to do this now. To be okay, and then it's going to be IKMIR. It's going to be Wilkes and we won't have to do our dial because that's our approach. I don't think so anyway. Because that's already been programmed in and it doesn't look like it has to be double shift like that. I might have typo, yeah. Let's just go back to arrival here. What I did before was, I did not click flight plan to lock it in. But that is locked in now and we're just going to go along here and have a look. Zoom it in. See, as you can see here and here, it's identical, almost. Looking just how it should be. Yeah, everything looks good. Almost everything. Almost everything. That one's got to go. I want to take it to the T-cell. I don't like going to the T-cell. Just gonna check my maps here, my charts. I just wanna double check something. Yeah, I see this is great. That approach is wrong. That's not right at all. It should be going up and around. That's going to 197, but we want to go into 25, and that's just not right. Let's have a look at this. Let's have a look. Yeah, we definitely want to... It does give us our dial. Yeah, it gets us our dial. Trying to on the fly and make them customize it there. Because control will probably give us our routine anyway. Now we're just going to jump back up here. Actually, we just sit that back. Mode and we are going to put in some information into the autopilot. So I just have to fix it for doing that by jointing the units over. Because it does, I complained a lot about that. We're going to cruise at 17,000 feet today. Okay, let's jump up on here and get our IPU going. So IPU power is on, then we start the IPU and generator complete air on for the IPU. Aircon research on. Packs left and right to order. One of them's already done in manual. Switching left to order. The IPU is now up and running. We can put the fast enough secret signs on. Now we want to just turn the IC and DC external power off. And then we can cancel our ground power. somehow. So I'm pretty sure your gear pins are inserted. Yes, because they aren't hanging out here if out of the basket if I'm quick roll. It's hard to see, but you can see a little red mark in there. And over here, and over here. So our gear pins are inserted. We want to... I'm actually confused here. Ground ops only. We are on ground. I can drive on. Can I just check that maybe? Because there have been a couple of times I've taken off with my gear pins and certainly not been able to ride by landing gear. But sometimes when I start up a flight with the 2400, the gear pins are stalled and sometimes I have inserted. And whenever I have inserted, I can't uninsert it. I don't understand. Working, so I just started checking this out. Because I just forgot to do this before, because it is a problem I've been having. I mean, whenever your gear pins aren't inserted, like I said, they aren't inserted every time I start a flight, I'm not able to stall them. And I have forgotten to look into that before this video. Let's just pluck out anyway.
Ladies and gentlemen.
And get this.
Just waiting for the last salvage to load on board, then we're about to get underway in a few minutes. On behalf of the entire flight crew, I wish you a pleasant flight.
That one's ready, we'll start Project Flight Lighter. Let me give this a quick Google. So I was doing the right thing by clicking on the back. I see the door is open on the ground. Well, this thing has better go in. Might be its surfaces. No, here we go. I have just worked it out. There we go. Might be it's hooked up for people out here as well that are watching this video.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm actually to keep
forward. Okay.
Just waiting for the last village to load on board. We've got to get on board in a few minutes. We have the entire flight crew on this ship.
What is the time? Alright, we've still got time before I depart. Just jump back up here, pilot starting switches. Standby on 1 and 2. Red circuit to 1. ready for out before start, to be honest. It's a bit early to get going here. Normally I'm using ground equipment and stuff to get the flight ready to go. So that normally takes a little bit of time doing that. Oh, my windshield demons just need to go on into this. So we'll just jump up here. Gotta remember where that one is. That's the one. And that should start turning off now. So yes, normally I got baggage loading and passengers loading and fuel trucks refueling, and that normally takes up that extra bit of time. So we do have a bit of time to see. Well, we're back into the way to suffer again. That looks to be a 707, yeah? To be Oyo Darling Airport. I don't know what he's doing, yeah? It doesn't even look like it's loaded properly.
Yankee Sierra Charlie Bravo Airport Information Uniform 0630 Zulu Weather Wind 188 at 16 Visibility 10 Sky Condition Few Clouds at 1800 Ceiling 3200 Broken Light Rain Temperature 12 Dew Point 5 QNH 1016 Advice on initial contact you have information Uniform Yankee Sierra Charlie Bravo Airport Information Uniform 0630 Zulu Weather Wind 188 at 16 Visibility 10 Sky Condition Few Clouds at 1800 Ceiling 3200 Broken Light Rain Temperature 12 Dew Point 5 QNH 1016 Advice on initial contact you have information Uniform Yankee Sierra
Alright, so I got the weather report, we've got the human height set, and as I was just up on the air, the weather is absolutely terrible. This is going to be an interesting flight. What we're going to do now, we're just going to go to control and get our clearance.
Delivery Qantas 1464. Information hotel request clearance.
Sometimes the IDO's not working to handle it, so it looks like that's kind of sad. How can I switch something? What? What have I done? This is on the trip you'll see here. Because I would like to get out the barge plans, but if I can't, then we'll just get in flights for safety. flight with 717 in the previous video that we had to see. It wasn't giving me radios and all of that for Canberra area. Really. There is no clearance radio in Canberra. We've got the ground. Let's see if we can shoot ground one to 172. We'll keep that for your reference.
Yankee Sierra Charlie Bravo Airport Information Vector 0630 Zulu Weather Wind 188 at 16 Visibility 10 Sky Condition Few Clouds at 1 South.
Clear delivery, Qantas 1464. Information, hotel, request clearance.
Qantas 1464. Sorry, unable at this time.
You're low B. Unless I can get clearance from Sydney. I should be IFR flight. What we'll do, we'll just try saying I'm getting used to using this ITC program still. I'm going to use it a few times so far.
Yankee Sierra Charlie Bravo Airport Information Whiskey 0630 Zulu Weather.
Clear delivery, Qantas 1464. Information, hotel, request clearance.
No, it must be out of lines. Again, I'm not used to using this traffic control program, nor am I used to being using traffic control at all, because normally I, back on flights MX, I didn't use it because it was too much of a strain in the system, and now that I've had 3D a few months, I want to get into doing it now. Since we don't have CSX, we do a manual course back. But what we'll do, we'll just do your before start checklist. It only takes a second there, when we search it off, if missing 1 or 2 to on, normal, RPM equals 1 or 2 to start with fairfile. When lights is required, I'll actually go into the notice on.
Well, we are ready for pushback.
We are ready now, please release point brake.
Parking brakes released.
Pushing back now, you're clear to start the engine number 2.
Come on, I don't like that push back. Good thing for this is on turned on. For just this reason. I just cleared him anyway. How's that going up?
Gentlemen, on behalf of our airline, we would like to welcome you on board
aboard Dash
Q400. What are you doing? Flight time today will be approximately 2 hours. Would you please fasten your seatbelts and refrain from smoking? If you want we would kindly ask you to contact us first. For takeoff and landing, the cellular phones may not be used during the entire flight. We wish you a pleasant stay on board.
Parking brake set. Can we get clearance at number one?
The tow is free and clear of my secure. Clear to start the engine number one. Have a nice flight.
headwind, we're going to have trouble taking off until you taxi down to the end of your runway. We could normally take off from here, but I'm not willing to do that today. I want that extra takeoff space. Have to come to a complete stop to rectify that. I wanted to do it now in case I forgot to do it in a couple minutes time. And it does track all your taxiing, so would like to take advantage of that. Thank you. mind is clearing up a little bit.
Qantas 1464. Our parking position is Terminal 1, Gate 12. Information, hotel, request clearance.
I just thought I'd give it another go. get that on 70 approach ready to go. I've got multiple frequency CFO approach, so hopefully that's the correct one. Turn 1,000 feet, sorry, when the landing lights off. True to your river in the shortness of the flight, I am going to keep the seatbelt signs on. Unlike George, which is not technically even unlike anymore. Altitude of 170. Got an I3, 29 miles, 29,000 feet. He's not going to be any issue for us. Possibly if I can fix an airport problem for camp, I'll have to see his exit might also help me solve the problem for ITC at camp. That's something else I'll look into. It's not leveling off there. It should have been, but it didn't. So we'll take that back down to 17,000 feet. Thank you. right, so now left right at 17,000 feet. Bits of this direction. At this point we can do RPM now to 900. And reset up our feet now for certainty. At Mista we expect it to be 7,000 feet.
Delivery Qantas 1464. Our parking position is Terminal 1, Gate 12. Information hotel request clearance. Clear delivery Qantas 1464. Information hotel request clearance.
Still not getting that clearance.
Clear delivery, Qantas 1464. Our parking position is Terminal 1, Gate 12. Information, hotel, request clearance.
What we're going to do is try to contact the Sydney Tower. Again, learning this ITC program.
Delivery Qantas 1464. Information hotel request clearance.
It was worth a shot. See if he can find anything here. We're apparently wanting to expect 3-4 left. So since that's what they want us to expect, that's what I'm just going to switch it to. Fire our dial, so switch this to 3-4 left. Sort that out now. So the same information. so I've never seen it before. Okay. Top off descent this after Welsh.
Delivery Qantas 1464. Information hotel request clearance.
I have no idea if I'm even doing the right thing with this ITC program. I've never had to try to get clearance mid-flight before or to get in contact with somebody to get me approach information. Approach, so I will contact him to initialize descent when it's time, and hopefully I'll be doing it for it. Something else we can also do. We can pop into here. Flight radar. Fuel okay. We're your only Qantas-linked flight going at the moment, and there we go. Can see all my information here about this current flight. But someone else uncertainly. He's on the FATSIM network. He's about to leave for half a month. So as you can see, so far with Project Fly, I've done 27 flights, 51 and a half hours. For Qantas Virtual, I have done 225 flights with a total of 639. That's 2.5 years of activity there. Have a number of aircraft around, a couple of which are heading for Sydney. That's got my old flight plan on it, which is fine. Start getting ready for this top of descent by setting your altitude down to zero for now. sure we have free enough here. Yes. So it will start descending now when we hit that right point. Or when we hit the TOD. For your approach at Sydney.
Qantas 1464 requesting to descend.
There's a number of frequencies here, so I'm not sure which is the right one.
Melbourne.
Oh, I got something, yeah. I heard something.
Virgin 114 to Melbourne Center, roger. Altimeter 2990.
No, that was default ITC. You don't want that. I need you actually kill your volume on that.
Qantas 1464 requesting to descend.
You know, there's like 10 different frequencies here and I'm just not going to go through them all. I'll try one more. Normally it automatically gives them to you. But obviously since your ITC doesn't seem to be functioning properly, it's not doing that.
Qantas 1464 requesting to descend.
Yeah, that's annoying. See if I can get some radio information from here. Maybe it might be more accurate. I don't think so. One would think I'd have some of the radios, yeah. Be handy. Oh, oh. My speed got too low. That's one thing about the Q400 dash 8. Got to constantly be looking at that speed. Constantly. I am just going to see if I can... there's a thing here somewhere for ITC. See if that does the trick. little bit of lag here.
A bit of freezing.
It does happen on descent as you get closer to your ground. It's just loading in text just to have more high detail when that happens. We'll go back to full RPM now. We'll be landing flaps 15 for this landing. Below 10,000 feet, so we want our landing lights on. Fasten seatbelts have already been on for this flight. Let's get a referee report. So don't think I'm going to be able to get ITC to work.
Yankee, Sierra, Bravo, Kilo, airport information, Alpha, 0730, Zulu, weather, wind, 237, at 1-8, visibility, 10, sky condition, ceiling, 4,500, broken, ceiling, 5,200, broken, temperature, 16, dew point, 9, QNH, 1013, advise on initial contact, you have information, Alpha, Yankee, Sierra, Bravo, Kilo, airport information, Alpha, 07.
Alright, so 1013, which is 29095, which I figured already is out. Yeah, so that's fine.
Qantas 1464 requesting to descend.
I'm going to have to do some more research into Crow ITCX. Watch some other YouTubers, Google some things, read the menu more, try to find out how to get ITC working during a flight. And if there's somewhere I can find your frequencies at, or just find out and altogether why it's just not wanting to work. Again, and I've said this a thousand times, and I'll say it one more time, I'm only new to using this program, so I'm still not 100% sure. Flight time so far. I missed it by a couple of minutes, so we're probably around 35, 36 minutes. There's not too much other traffic around coming into land, so we'll just keep an eye on the runway as we're coming in. 12175, I've just seen a frequency. Before I try to tune NAD, we want to switch the NAV source to IOS. There we go, and click approach mode. We should intercept the localizer shortly. No, 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 what are you doing? What are you doing? That's okay.
See if we can... Clear delivery, Qantas 1464. Information India, request clearance. Qantas 1464, request to descent.
Nah, it's still not working. There we go, we've got the localizer. We're on approach mode. Let's get some flaps down. So 3-4 left to see, your autopilot seems to be getting us lined up with our... Get that speed up a bit more, getting a bit low. We'll get 10 flaps. We'll do flaps 15 when we put the gas down. Again, it's just racing as it's loading and stuff. At least it doesn't crash like Flight Sim X used to at this point.
2500.
Have to heads up display here, but I'm not going to be using that for this landing. But I'm about to disengage your autopilot and take off your aircraft. A bit more. I like to let the dust side line up as much as it can for me. Because I do find it a little difficult. We're looking really good here, so the autopilot has just lined up beautifully. Just watching that speed.
What's
oh,
thunder?
And the aircraft is mine.
Minimums.
Landing. Coming a little bit off center here.
Sink rate.
10.
I can be a little all off your place when landing. I do have trouble with it sometimes. That's why I like to leave the landing autopilot on as long as possible. So we'll stop your flight clock. Up. Control lock on. RPM to 750. Spoilers up into the taxi. Landing lights on. Taxi lights on. Off and on. IPU power and start. Generator. I did forget to do your TCAS at the beginning of this flight though. And here's our Virgin Blue. But it's now known as Virgin Australia. That's landing here off on 16 left. forward turn on this one. I wasn't going to, but I just changed my mind. Gate did we say? 19, yes. Where am I here? Shot it, so we'll just do it quick. Loop around here, we've got the room. Can turn on the dime. That was 16, yeah, I was seeing it the wrong way around, thinking it was 19. 17. Definitely we all and truly went past it. 19. I'm familiar with the gate numbers for Q400, I'd say, because I've quite often been on your flights before. And I overshot that a little bit. Oh, I have to try strike through one of my baggage vehicles. Well, that's a little bit wrong, but I don't have to listen to turned on just for this reason. Now let's see how well I can do this. A little bit too slow, yeah? Turning it, it's because I've got the right engine off, left engine off, which just proceeds from the Q400. This makes it a bit hard to taxi. Actually making it incredibly hard to turn here, it just doesn't want to go. Oh, that was a bad idea, shutting that engine down. Oh, what just happened here? Yeah. Okay, so taxi lights off and entrance off. That wasn't a very good parking, though, I'm sorry. Okay, now this I'll turn around, shut down, check what's complete of. So I think that's a bit of a longer flight than normal. That's it.